on to our next speaker, next and final speaker, Dr. Mina Zarei. She is an assistant professor of physics at the Institute for Advanced Studies in Basic Science in Iran. And she's going to talk to us about the synchronization of adaptive networks of Sakaguchi-Kuramoto oscillators.
Hello, everybody. I'm going to speak about the synchronization of adaptive networks of Sakaguchi-Kuramoto oscillators. The motivation behind this work is that if we consider the cortex, we can, in the resting state, we can see that we can see that there are lots of the nodes with high frequencies, the yellow ones, and a few nodes with the low frequency, the blue ones. And in addition, frequencies are assumed to be a function of the anatomical node strength. I mean that these blue nodes with low frequencies have a high number of connections, and the yellow nodes with high frequencies have low number of connections. This is from higher to lower connectivities. For example, we can see it better in the schematic graph. It looks like a star that the hub is the low frequency nodes with a lot of connections, and the high frequency nodes have a low number of connections. The question is that, can adaptation lead to these structural differences between the high and the low frequency nodes? So we are going to think about this during this seminar. Here I use the synchronization dynamics. You know this, for example, here we see the synchronized movement of the dancers. If we have a network of phase oscillators, then we couple them together, we can see the time evolution of the phase of each oscillator according to the Kuramoto model. Here, theta dot is the time evolution of the I oscillator. Omega is its natural frequency. Lambda is the coupling strength. And R is the adjacency matrix that the structure of network is hidden inside. So here we have the interaction term. If you look at this equation, this equation is time reversal symmetric. I mean that if I change time to minus time, nothing will change. But if I add a mismatch parameter to the equation, which is called the Sakaguchi-Kuramoto model, mismatch parameter breaks time reversal symmetry. We are going to see that this parameter, how affects the dynamics and structural changes of the network during the adaptation. At first, I need a measure to quantify the level of synchrony. I use the Kuramoto order parameter, which is defined like this, and it changes from 0 to 1. When it close to 1, we are in the synchronous state. I mean, the phase of oscillators are close together. And when it is close to 0, we are in the asynchronous state. I mean that the phase of oscillators scattered along the unit circle. If you have a network of phase oscillators that are evolved according to the Kuramoto dynamics, at first they are not synchronized, so the order parameter is close to 0, and after a while their synchronization increases to the certain level. The synchronization value at the infinite time or stationary time is called a stationary order parameter. When here I speak about the order parameter, I mean the stationary order parameter. But suppose that we have a network that with phase oscillators connected to each other with the Kuramoto model, the nodes are different and everything. But the reality is that the structure of the network is not really fixed in reality, but it changed during the dynamics. There are two well-known adaptation rules, Hebb rules, and anti-Hebb rules, that both of them are important for the function of the brain in the memory, in the learning, and vice versa. Hebb rules, we can say that if the link, the connection between two nodes that are often synchronized during the dynamics will be strengthened after a while, and the connection between two nodes that are often not synchronized during the dynamics will be weakened after a while. The anti-Hebb rule is opposite, and the Hebb and anti-Hebb rules, both of them lead to different structures. Here we use the rewiring two different rewiring processes to model Hebbian and anti-Hebbian actually learning. Suppose that in a time during the dynamics, two nodes are connected and they are asynchronous. Their phases are not closed. We rewire the links to another random node. So after a while, when we do this several times during the dynamics, the links between the asynchronous nodes will be weakened, and then the links between the synchronous nodes will be strengthened. So this is the Hebbian rewiring. In anti-Hebbian rewiring, we did reversal things. So if two nodes are connected and they are during the dynamics almost synchronized, we rewire their links to another random nodes. So during the dynamics, the links between the synchronous nodes will be weakened. So we have the anti-Hebbian rule, we have the Hebbian rules, and these two change the structure networks in different ways. Here are the results. If you have the Kuramoto model without the mismatch parameter and anti-Hebbian rewiring, suppose that the initial structure of the network is homogeneous. I mean that we have a uniform frequency for each node, but for each node, the number of links or the degree of each node is also similar. We run the Kuramoto model on these networks for a certain value of the coupling constant, and we see that during the time, the order parameter is low, so it's not synchronized. We started to do the rewiring according to anti-Hebbian rules, and we see that when we do the different rewirings, the synchronization increases, and after a while, it reaches to the stationary high level of global synchronization. So the anti-Hebbian rewiring leads us to the global synchronization and how it changes the structures. If we see the structure is not homogeneous, it's inhomogeneous. And here the size of the nodes shows the number of links that connected to that nodes. So we see that there are some nodes with a high number of links, which we call the hubs. And the color shows the actually the frequency of the nodes. So gray is the mean frequency of the nodes. Red is high frequency of the nodes, and blue is low frequency of the nodes. So the nodes that the frequency are far from the average, actually they are hub. They take a lot of links. And we can see this here better. Here is the degree of the nodes that I said, the number of links that connected to each node. And here are this value. I mean that the natural frequency of each node minus the average frequency. So when we say zero, it means that the node has the average frequency. When we say minus two, the node has a lower frequency than average, and two is higher frequency than average. We see that there is a correlation between the degree of the nodes and the absolute value of these values, or we say that the natural frequencies. But if you remember the motivation part, in the resting state, we see that the nodes with low frequency has high number of links, but the nodes with high frequencies has low number of links. So this adaptation doesn't lead out to that correlation that we mentioned in the motivation. But if we add a mismatch parameter and do the anti-Hebbian learning, we see again that anti-Hebbian learning leads to the global synchronization, but less than when the alpha is zero. And if we plot the similar plots like before, the degree of each node versus the each average frequencies, so zero is the average frequencies. Here we have nodes with low frequencies. Here we have nodes with high frequencies. When alpha is zero, we have symmetric around the zero. But when we add the mismatch parameter, that can be really a small amount of the delay in the network, and the time reversal of the equation will be broken, then the symmetry around the mean also will be broken. Now we have the nodes with low frequencies have a higher actually degree than the nodes with high frequency. It's similar to the things that we said in the motivation. And this minimum will be changed. We can find it analytically. I don't speak about this now. But how about the Hebbian rewiring? If we do Hebbian rewiring, we don't have a structure with global synchronization, but we reach to the clustered structures that in each cluster, the nodes are synchronized, but the clusters are not synchronized to each other. So if we plot the adjacency metrics for different mismatch parameters, we will see these clusters. So here the colors shows the probability that two nodes are connected. So yellow ones that they are almost connected together. We see the nodes are ordered from the low frequency to the high frequency. So the node zero have the lowest frequency, the node 100 highest frequency, and then the node 50 almost the mid frequency. We can see that when we have zero mismatch parameter, I mean that the Kuramoto equation we have, and we have time reversal symmetric, and evolve the network with these that dynamics, we will reach to a structure that it is symmetric around the mean frequency. So we have a large cluster around the mean frequency and small clusters around these large clusters. But when we add this mismatch parameter, the symmetry around the mean frequency will be broken, and the nodes with low frequencies will have a higher number of links than the nodes with high frequencies. So if we want to have a network that we said, like the things that we said in the motivation, that the nodes with high and the low frequencies have different structures, we need some mismatch parameters or some delay in our dynamics. The results so is that the anti-Hebbian dynamics leads to the global synchronization with frequency degree correlation. Correlated structures. The Hebbian dynamics leads to the structured, clustered structures with local synchronized clusters. And the mismatch parameters actually causes the structure of the evolved networks have asymmetry respect to the mean natural of frequencies, as we see something like that in nature. These are the collaborators of these works, and thank you for your attention.
Thank you so much, Mina. That was really great. We had a question in the chat, but I think you've already answered that, which was about the definition of adaptation. And I also actually had a very similar question, because to me, adaptation is, the way I think of adaptation is more on the network adapts, and so it no longer fires anymore. And so you would expect there to be either lesser degree of connectivity or some other type of anti-connectivity in the sense. So I was wondering if you could elaborate a little bit more on the actual definition for adaptation.
In the adaptation, actually, the structure is changed during the dynamics. So we have always different states for each nodes during the dynamics. And it's a little difference between the Hebbian that we define here and the Hebbian that we define like STDP, because they have that phase lag in the time. But in each instant of the time, actually, according to the state of the nodes at that time, we will have this adaptation until that we reach to the stationary point. I don't know if I answered your question or not.
Yeah, I had a related question regarding how stochastic these processes are in terms of, like, if you shuffled all the nodes, let's say, and you had a different starting structure, then how would that influence your
It's really robust. Yes, it's really robust. We did it. Actually, the results are for the average of our different initial conditions and the different networks, and the results are qualitatively robust.
That's really cool. All right. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I don't think we have any more questions, and I think we are right on time for the session to end.